how dangerous are Antarctica's volcanoes, really? Well, not only can Antarctic volcanoes sometimes disrupt, damage, or even destroy scientific bases in specific areas, but they even have the potential to affect commercial activities on other continents as well. This includes disrupting regional air traffic, or in a worst-case scenario, cause a volcanic winter that has the potential to cause a temporary degree of famine and precipitation changes at multiple locations around the planet. In other words, we should not take Antarctic volcanoes for granted just because the vast majority of them are so remote. Take for example the Deception Island volcano. If we just look at this volcano from satellite, we can easily spot its massive central caldera that turned what was a singular landmass into a ring-shaped island, much like Santorini's major eruption did in Greece during 1610 BCE. The caldera at Deception Island formed via a mid-end VEI-6 explosive eruption, marking the largest explosive eruption Antarctica has experienced during the last 10,000 years, forming around 2030 BCE. This is seemingly linked with a volcanic winter that lowered world temperatures for a few years, but its effects it had on societies, if there were any, were not thoroughly recorded. However, what we are 100% certain of is that Deception Island is the only Antarctic volcano to have caused a complete evacuation of the island it was on due to eruptions which caused damage to buildings in 1967, 1969, and then again in 1970. These eruptions formed a brand new set of up to 300-meter or 984-foot-wide Mare explosion craters. And, since Deception Island is located in vaguely close proximity to the busiest airport in the Antarctic, any future eruption it produces, which are universally a level of explosive, have the potential to disrupt regional air traffic. It is for this very reason that Deception Island earns the top spot among 32 Antarctic volcanoes in the hazard reading assessment I have made, which uses the US Geological Survey methodology linked in this scientific paper. But what about the other 31 volcanoes? Before I unveil the rest of the list, I want to first clarify what I counted as an Antarctic volcano. Either a volcano physically on the Antarctic continent, or a non-mid-ocean ridge volcano further south than 49 degrees south latitude, which was not part of South America. This means that South Africa's Marion Island volcano won't be included, but Australia's Big Ben volcano will be included. With that out of the way, here are the results. 19 of the volcanoes are very low threat, 10 full in the low threat designation, 1 falls in the moderate threat designation, 2 full in the high threat designation, and 0 full into the highest threat category, the very high threat designation. Since these volcanoes are spread across 25 million square kilometers or 4.8% of Earth's surface, it should come as no surprise that there are clusters of them which exist due to vastly differing reasons. The Baleni hotspot, Kerguelen hotspot, and Bouvet hotspot are each responsible for one or more volcanic islands, but only two of these are inhabited either always or seasonally. The rest exist due to rifting, ancient weak spots in the crust, or tectonic plate collisions. Let's first look at the most densely populated portion of Antarctica that includes the actively erupting Mount Erebus volcano, with McMurdo Station to the south hosting 1,200 people in the summer. While the Mount Erebus stratovolcano is located 37 kilometers away, it has twice in the last 40,000 years produced ultraplanian eruptions. If a similar eruption was to occur in the future, it could create secondary lahars or glacial floods termed eucolops that could impact McMurdo Station or its resupply, hence why Mount Erebus is the second most potentially dangerous Antarctic volcano. As for Mount Melbourne in third place, that is because any future eruption from it could theoretically generate eucolops, which in my opinion could have the potential to damage 3 downslope scientific outposts. Penguin Island earns the next spot due to its semi-frequent explosive eruptions in somewhat close proximity to the continent's most active airport. Freeman Peak, Mount Rittmann, and Berlin have each produced one or more VEI-4 or larger explosive eruptions in the past, so they could theoretically have the potential to disrupt 4 southern hemisphere air traffic if they were to ever produce a similarly explosive eruption again. So, while the overall answer to how dangerous Antarctic volcanoes are is it depends, you could also say low but non-zero, with the potential to cause temporary climactic effects worldwide and regional flight disruptions in the far southern hemisphere during an unusually explosive Plinian or Ultra Plinian eruption.